Good morning, welcome to Goodwill Commodities. In this video presentation we are going to see how we can trade in MCX crude oil today. Before looking into that, let us see what happened yesterday and what we expected yesterday. The chart which you are seeing is the Goodwill Commodities charting tool. Yesterday we had our weekly analysis. What we expected yesterday was, we expected if the price is opening near or below 5960, if the price was trading below 5960, we expected crude to stay in selling. So we put a keen watch on the price opening. So now let us see what happened after that. Now we can see that this long ash color candlestick that indicates yesterday's price opening, which clearly indicates the market opened with a gap. Whenever there was a gap or spike down opening, like what happened on yesterday's market, we consider the LTP as the price opening. We don't take into account the market spike as the opening. On seeing this long dropped ash color candlestick, we can notice that the price was trading below 5920, which was clearly indicating us that the market has got the ability to go down, having 5960 as the key resistance zone. As a follower of our presentation, we made it very clear in the yesterday's weekly analysis the importance of 5960 and 6000 and 6020 zones. You can go to our blog website www.onlinecommoditytradingmcx.com, or you can go to our YouTube channel, Facebook, and you can see the earlier videos. Now let us see what happened after that. After the price opening, our charting platform also indicating that the momentum was on the selling side. So after the price opening, it is a straightaway drop, because so many traders like us, they were watching the market and they expected if the price is going below 5920, they expected the market to be in selling. So there was a selling pressure that pushed the price down to the target zone of 5860. So initially the market reached our first target of 5860. So after that also the price was coming down and it created a low of near 5850s. But you may notice that the market was taking some support near 5860. It is no wonder, because I will show you the price actions. Let us see the yesterday's price action. I will describe you, I will explain you the importance of this 5860 zone again. So after that there was a pullback. So having 5860 as a support, then the price tried to move up above 5920, which is the intermediate resistance. So the price couldn't clear that, there was a drop down, then it is a pure consolidation. After the continuation of trend and after reaching the target zone of 5860, the market started consolidating. So the price closed near 5890. Now let us see the open high low close analysis compared with the previous day. It's very clear the entire price action, what happened in the yesterday's market when comparing to the previous day, that was on Friday market, the entire trading zone was below the Friday's market. There is no doubt, apart from this spike opening, if you see, all the price action was below 5920. If you compare the yesterday's opening, as I told you earlier, we will be focusing only on the LTP after 10 o'clock. We don't take into account the spike as a price opening. So when you compare the price opening, the market closed just below the market opening. Now let us see what we can do today. Before that, let us see the price action, what happened around 5860 on the previous days. Let me push up, let me move this to the earlier days. Now you can notice whenever I place the cursor on any particular candlestick, you can see the date and time below. On November 28th of, you can see the price came down to 5860, where it got some support and there was a pullback that pushed the price towards 5920. You may notice that there was a long consolidation near this zone. So out of this pressure, what happened, from 5920, the market was pushed towards the key zone of 5960, which is the trend deciding zone. So from that the market gained momentum, and from that you notice that the price went up till 6060. This was the price action that happened on November 20th and 21st of this month. Let me pull back again to show the importance of this zone again. Now you may notice that the same type of price action you witnessed in the yesterday's market. After the price dropping from 5920, the price came down till 5840s. In this zone, the market was taking a lot of support. See, if you compare the same pattern with yesterday's market, it may look the same. So after reaching this zone, after coming down just below 5860, there was a bit of consolidation, and then the price closed near 5890s. So this, you can notice that the same price action that happened in yesterday's market. So today, what we can do today, why I'm saying this is that you should know the importance of this 5860, and you should have these types of price action in your mind so that you can make a valuable trading decision. And here you may notice that after the price closing near 5900 zone or 5890 zone, the next day, that was on 20th of November, the price opened near 5920. Please know, or please follow this very carefully, because you are going to see the same type of price action today. That is why I am stressing this point and showing the importance of this particular zone. The price opened near 5920 and there was a lot of consolidation here. Then there was a drop down and there was a pullback. Now let us go back and see what we can do today. So just a second. So what can be the possible price opening for today? That is going to be the key area. If the price is going to open below the yesterday's market price closing, for example, let us assume if the price is opening near 5880s or below this, that can give us a clear signal for all the traders. Still the momentum is on the selling side, but according to the NYMEX price direction, which we use to predict the market opening in MCX, we don't take in the rupee factor into account. There may be minor changes in the price opening because we are posting this video very earlier, and today the price opening is also influenced by the dollar rupee factor. So on seeing the NYMEX price direction, we can come to a conclusion. The price is expected to open near 5920. So that is going to be the key. That is the reason I showed you the LA price action, what happened on 20th of November. If the price is opening near 5920, it is a clear resistance zone and also a very important zone. We should closely monitor what is happening near 5920. As per the trend is down, but we should put a close watch near 5920, because if the price is taking some support near 5920, and if it can put a closing near or above 5960, that will entirely change the scenario. Because as I told you again and again, we are repeating, you will see the same type of price action that happened on 21st of November. So put a close watch here. Today also, we are expecting crude oil to stay in downtrend. There is no change in our focus, but please follow these zones very carefully. These are all very important zones, and this is going to be this 5920 and 960 is the zone for this particular contract. If you can put a close watch in this zone, you can win easily in this particular contract for the entire month. So today also, we are expecting crude to continue its selling, because these are all the zones which you should put a lot of focus on. So thanks a lot for watching our videos. Happy trading. Take care. Bye.